and a synthetic polymers. That was the last choice we would have. But of course, there's a lot of suspicious feeling about biodegradable building materials. When it's really biodegradable, it degrades. So we made a design. We went to an architect, he made the design. We had a very small bit, four houses to start with. And they made a nice design with all the light coming in as much as possible. There was a small space inside where the ventilation was being, where the indoor climate was being kept. We were looking very carefully into what kind of walls we would construct, because when you make construction based on bio-based materials, there is moisture absorption, there is moisture regulation, there is damp open, we call that, that the moisture can go through the wall. When there's a lot of moisture inside, it will go out. And when it's out, there should be a barrier that it's not coming in. So that's some thinking about how to make this construction. Well, this is the result. We have been using a lot of bio-based materials, although there were some restrictions because not all the materials we would like to use were available on the market. Currently, we are making an inventory on renewable building materials, which would be become a catalog of products based on bio materials that can be used in industry. So we want to make a list of the suppliers of the resources and the methods of new building methods with this bio-based materials, which would be wood products, wood fiber panels and boards, non-wood products, adhesive coatings and building chemicals. If we go into detail about what kind of products we have, of course wood is the most likely material. Here you will see around, everything is wood. But it should be wood with an eco label. It should be sustainably produced. It should be replanted when it's being cut. It shouldn't add to new deforestation. And so these type of things are very important, especially in the Netherlands. This eco labeling is something that is being looked at. Then there's the wood-based reassembled product. Then you need a glue. What kind of glue would you need? This would be one of the problems now. That is also petrochemical glues, emitting volatile organic components in the air. That is the formaldehyde emissions that is being under pressure. So there's a need for renewable glues, and you can make those. You can make those from this biorefinery processing we are designing. You have the fiber boards. There are different types, high density, medium density, or particle boards. You have the veneer multiply panels, oriented strand boards. You can use the cellulose from wood for insulation. That is a woolly material that is in between walls that is keeping heat out or heat in. That's depending on where you live. And there's also other non-wood products. Recently, this multiply construction right here, different layers of wood in different directions are being assembled to make very strong and very long beams, which never could be done with natural wood because of the strength properties. And of course, the glue you use here, it should be very good, otherwise your construction will not hold. And when it becomes wet or it starts swelling, you have a problem with that. So, besides wood, there is movement building products which you can make from bamboo or bamboo composites, but also fiber crops like we have in the Netherlands, flax and hemp, with more tropical jute and quinoa, and then other fiber crops are being used to make non-woven insulation for sound and for heat, but also particle boards. Wheat and rice straw bales, you can make compressed panels, you can make MDF type of materials. Reeds and canes, palm fronds for making detached roofs. Coconut fiber, mats have been used for floor covering, but also compressed binders boards we have developed, I will come to that later. Cork and other bark residues can be used as a building construction material. One of the problems with straw bale building, which you know, something people do in the Netherlands, to make a building with the straw bales, which is a quite complicated thing. It's taking a lot of time to make it. It's a handwork. People are, and it's very sensitive to moisture. So when you're building, you have to think of protecting it against moisture. When it's built, it's a very nice and comfortable construction in the house, but it has some disadvantages. Like, it's not an industrial process. And it's, to me, I would think we can use the straw, but reassemble the straw, make panels in an industry, and then distribute it as a building material and not in this way. And of course, there's always concern about fire hazard. When you use biomaterials and you don't protect it, there's a risk of fire. And there's protection against fungi and insects. That's another issue to deal with. There are a number of typical things like sheet wool insulation. In the Netherlands, there's a company supplying sheet wool. They put it in the walls, and that has a very good heat insulation. Another possibility is shell lime mortar. You can make shells from the sea, and you can make them into mortar, which is a very good substitute for cement type of mortars. To protect your house from moisture, from the soil coming up, shells are being used in underfloor barriers. And that is something in the Netherlands, because we have a very low country with high water, this is a solution for keeping your house less, or keep it more dry. Silica ash is a very nice substitute for cement. You can make silica from rice straw, from rice husk, and you can use it as a ceramic binder. And that is something that is being developed in India, and I know there's also additions to concrete to use a renewable mineral binder. Here you see an example of this insulation with wool. I'm not sure it's good for tropical countries, but then there's another topic about non-wood building products, that's the coatings and adhesives, because wood and fiber products are sensitive to moisture and to attack of insects and fungi. You need to protect it, and there are different ways of coatings. Most of the coatings that are used now are synthetics, or epoxies, or urethanes, but you can use plant oils and latex, start-based adhesives, coatings, and if you do the right chemistry there. And we have been doing a lot of work on lignin. Lignin is the component in wood that keeps the wood fibers together. And if you extract it for making paper, for example, the lignin is now burned because it it's not a very easy way of converting it, but people use it as a glue. And that